But jail. Are you listening to me?
Listen, babe, I'm a little tired. Shall we lay down though and have some little rest? Your husband is not at home, is he?
No, he's at work. He won't be at home until midnight. Fred, do you think I will be a star one day? Come on, Fred, say it.
You're my little star.
I want to meet your friend at the club, huh? Fred, when am I going to meet your friend who owns the club?
It's getting late, come on.
But I've been working on my act. Every time I get an idea, I write it down in my diary.
Oh, wake up, Roxy. You will never be a star. You are a housewife with no freaking talent. And I'm just a furniture salesman.
But that night, you said you know the guy. You know the owner of the club. He can help me.
Look, that night, I had sales. I told him whatever you wanted to hear. We had some laughs. Just leave it there. I'm so bored of the same old story again and again.
You lied to me.
I guess so beautiful. That's the life, sweetheart.
You big liar. You son of a witch. Hey, Fred.
Yeah?
Nobody walks out on me.
You don't want to do that, sweetheart. Please. No, please. Please.
Playing games with another man. This time, you pushed too far, you little witch! Boy, what an idiot I was!
You double-crosser! You big blabbermouth! You said you would protect me! How could you do this to me, to your own wife?!
You've been lying to me, Roxy! You told me he was a brother, and all the while he was a boy toy!
You're a shameful husband! Yeah, I shot him! He was trying to walk out on me! That's coward! Look, it's true! I shot him! But he was trying to burgle me! It was a self-defense!
From what I hear, he's been burgling you quite a lot, Missy. 3 times a week for the last month.
Well, that's a pretty cold blood to murder, Mr. Dart. Take her down there. Come on.
They'll hang you for that one. You will die.
Hang me? Amos, did you hear what he said? Help me, full of pain! I don't want to go to jail! I don't want to die! Amos, help!
Woman.
Annoy you. Small things, unimportant things, but just annoying.
Hey, Liz, bring me my beer.
Hey, Liz, bring me my beer.
Annoying, right? But wait, here comes the second order.
Hey, Liz, bring me some chips.
Oh, he loved eating chips in front of the TV while watching his stupid football matches. But wait, that's not all. Here comes the worst part. He loved chewing gums. But no, he didn't just chew the gum. He popped it. He was there, sitting in his chair, ignoring me all the time. So, I said, if you pop that gum one more time, I will kill you. He was there staring at me, saying nothing. God damn, I was furious. But he found it enjoyable. He said,
really? You're gonna kill me?
And burst into laughter. I just wanted to end his stupid and useless laughter. So I took the shotgun and I fired two warning shots into his head. Well, I told you I'm not guilty, am I?
No, you're not guilty.
So, I told you! second. He was broken with my number 17. I mean dead. I told you, I'm not guilty. Am I?
No, you're not guilty!
Playing the biggest shows with the biggest stars. I did not want to see him.
Jess, your husband is dead. You killed him.
Oh, well, forget it then.
Hey, get out of my spot!
I was just... meet Velma Kelly.
Velma Kelly? Gosh, I'm sure pleased to meet you. Miss Kelly, can I ask you something? They said that I should die because of my crime. They said they will ask for the maximum punishment. They want me to die.
Welcome to the club.
I'm scared. I need help. Can you give me some advice?
Look, honey,
I don't give advice. I don't know who you are and I don't want to know.
I don't need your friends.
Gee, thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
I'd like to help you.
First of all, when you plan on telling the jury,
I guess I'll just tell them the truth.
Never tell the truth when you enter the jail.
You can't tell them that, dearie.
Tell them the truth, the jury?
That's about as corny as it gets.
Well, what should I say then?
That.
I didn't do it!
So who did?
Well, I don't know. Can't remember a thing.
Or, but I'm sure I didn't do it.
Or,
I have the kindest heart in the world. I'm not guilty.
No, I'm not.
Who's your lawyer?
I ain't got a lawyer. But they say a guy named Chili is a good one.
That's Liz's lawyer. She said he is the one of the greatest.
Oh.
Hey, Mama, would you be here and wake me up for the lunch?
My pleasure, Belle.
Whoa.
She wears nothing but Blasinosa's perfume and never makes her own bed.
Wait. Bye. I can talk.
You have to make the bed.
No, Mama takes care of it.
Jess, don't clean the toilets.
What? Me again?
Jess? Quick! Don't try, Mama, crazy! Well, what was I saying? Mama pays Mama $5 a week.
She takes 15 Romanian cents and she does it.
And also, Mama pays her son to do her laundry. That's $5 more. And she wants her meals from the Woosters around the corner, and that's 20 a week.
And you know who's defending her, don't you?
No, who? Lawyer Chili?
Mr. Billy Flynn.
Who is Billy Flynn?
Best criminal lawyer in all of Chicago.
How do you get Billy Flynn? You give Mama $100, then she makes a phone call.
Oh, shoo.
And how much does the lawyer get?
$5,000?
Worth every cent.
Never lost a female case client yet.
Never?
Never. I need blood to make that phone call for you.
Oh, shoo. That's a huge amount of money. Where am I going to get $5,000?
Think, Roxy.
Find a way. Or else, you're going to die. Too young to die.
$5,000? Wow.
Well, if you won't believe, she is paid. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you like to meet this guy?
Damn. Let's welcome to the stage the Silver Tongue Pierce of the Courtroom.
The one, the only,
Billy Flynn.
Love.
Give me two
eyes are blue, softly saying,
I need you.
Let me see her standing there, and honest mister, I'm a millionaire. I don't care for any fine attire, Vanderbilt might admire. No, no, not me. All I care about is love.
Actually,
I'm always honest to my clients, and honestly, always works. Don't forget it.
Ask him how many cases has he lost.
Okay, how many cases?
40!
40? Are they all dead?
Like, no. Some of them killed themselves, and other ones just didn't want to leave jail, and the other ones lied in the courtroom, and that makes us lose everything, actually.
Mr. Chili, I don't want to go to jail, and I don't want to die. Mr. Billy, do I have to pay you $5,000?
Look, sweetie, if you don't have the money, call to Mr. Chili right now.
I'll have to make some arrangements, Mr. Billy.
Roxy didn't sleep, and she came up with a brilliant idea. Guess who is going to help her find the money?
Amos, the Amore guy, her dearest husband.
Let's see if she can convince him to find the money.
Here, she's waiting for her savior.
Oh, Amos, I know you would come. Amos, I know I've been sinful, but I'm changing my ways. All I want now is to make it up to you for what I did. And I will, Amos, I will, just as soon as I get out of here. And you can help me do that. See, there is this lawyer. He never lost a case like mine. He is the best.
And he costs $5,000.
Amos, you must help me.
I'm not your butler, Roxy. I'm tired of helping you clean your mess. The answer is no.
Amos, I know I cheated, and I know I lied. Amos, I even stole money from your pants pockets while you're sleeping.
You did?
Yes, but I never stopped thinking. My Amos, so manly, so attractive, so sexy.
You find me attractive?
Yes, my amor.
Manly and sexy?
Yes, my love.
Honest?
Honest.
But $5,000?
I need you, goddammit!
Okay, come now, Roxy. I'll get it for you.
Amos, go quick! Do your best! I trust you!
And that lady reporter from the Evening Side will be there too.
She loves everything Kimberly says and does.
She will eat everything we give her and write even more on her newspaper.
Her name is Miss Sunshine.
Yeah. All right, Tamia. Organize a press conference and make sure that Miss Mary Sunshine is there.
Sorry.
the earliest possible date. Are there any questions, Sunshine?
Foxy Heart, I'm curious about your story.
Sunshine, you're shining, as usual.
Interesting. So, Mr. tell me a little about life of jazz and alcohol in Chicago. Do you have any advice for young girls? Should they be scared of these devilish sins?
Jazz. I like it. Alcohol. Help!
Miss Hart thinks that this was a tragic combination of jazz and alcohol of Chicago, which caused all this drama. Next question, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to say how happy I am that you all came to see me at my darkest time.
Miss Hart is very pleased.
I bet you want to know why I shot the bastard!
Mr. Billy Flynn in the press conference rag. Notice how his mouth never moves. Almost.
Where'd you come from?
Mississippi.
And your parents?
Very wealthy.
Where are they now?
6 feet under.
But she was granted one more star.
The command of the Sacred Heart.
How old were you?
Don't remember.
Then what happened?
I met Amos and he stole my heart away. Convinced me to elope one day.
Oh, my poor dear, I can't believe what you've been through. A convent girl, a runaway marriage. Now tell us, Roxy.
Who's Becky Lee?
My ex-boyfriend.
Why'd you shoot him?
I was leaving.
Was he angry?
Like a madman. Till I said, Fred, move along.
She knew that she was doing wrong.
Then describe it.
He came toward me
with a pistol
from my euro.
Did you fight him?
Like a tiger.
He had strength and she had none.
And yet we both reached for the gun. Yes, we both reached for the gun. Choo-choo, jump the track, I get my legs to bring it back. Stay away from jazz and liquor. And the men who play for fun. That's the thought that came upon me when we both reach for the gun.
Understandable.
Yes, it's perfectly understandable.
Reached for the...
They're coming. Mr. Chili, I'd like you to meet Sir William.
Well, hello, Sir William. All right. I don't want to take this conversation any longer than it should be. The thing is, we need someone to learn what is the actual story of Roxy's crime.
First of all, you don't give me no right. That, you tell me nicely. Give me the details, and then I will decide whether I like to spend Roxanne in jail or not.
Emma, what is this guy talking about?
Mr. Chili, he's a little tense. He doesn't like getting orders from strangers.
I don't like getting orders from strangers, man.
He doesn't like getting orders from strangers?
He doesn't.
I don't.
Okay, that's enough. Sir William, my name is Chili Fire. I'm a lawyer, and there's this case that I want to take, but however, my brother Billy Flint got the case.
He always gets the most famous cases.
I know Billy Flint. He's an ass and wins every case. I don't support what he does.
Yes, he's known notoriously for his way of winning cases, and that's exactly what I want to talk about with you. The new case that he took away from me, Roxy's crime. As you know, Billy will try to create an innocent story to her and show this lady as an innocent girl in front of the jury.
Mr. Chili, Mr. Sir William, I told Mr. Chili that you know people inside the jailhouse. Like Cornelia was your...
Cornelia! Never mention her name! I have never seen such a witch in my life. She is the reason they came and spy, but sick of her cheating and tired of her lies, deceiving me all the time. I did become a spy naturally, just to take her dirty shit. And I did. I hate her. I want her dead.
Calm down, Coolio. Don't lose your temper. We need this Cornelio bitch.
Okay, correct me if I'm wrong. You want me to learn what Roxy actually did and ended up in this jail. Her is Billy Flynn.
Yes. The press conference took place yesterday and tomorrow, and in the news, everyone will think Roxy is innocent. I don't want that, Sir William. I want the case of Roxy. Can you help me?
Give me 1 hour, and I will learn everything, including the future plans of Mr. Billy Flynn as well.
Okay, meet me here in 1 hour, but don't forget the picture. Roxy. Bye.
For the gun! Only Roxy did! She had been cheating on Amos for about quite a long time. And this guy, Fed, kept telling her lies to make her famous and all. And one day, she realized that she had been deceived. And one day, she took the gun out of the drawer and shot him twice in the head.
Holy shit! Sir William, thank you for your partnership. Come on, Emma, let's go. As you know, the prisoners want something from the mama.
They want to see their lovers.
They want to make a bond with some people.
But they need permission.
They give that permission.
They certainly need to be good to mama.
Mama, I have done nothing but be a polite young lady who happens to smile, who happens to be loyal to you all the time. Why won't you let me see this chilly eye?
Dear Liz, you just can't get enough losing, can you? I mean, what's with you and this chilly guy?
Well, first of all, he's quite handsome.
Handsome is one of the most important qualities for a good lawyer.
Handsome. He's loyal.
Who loyal?
He buys me tiny little presents every time he comes to visit me.
Presents? Liz, do you think these will get you out of prison? I mean, the guy keeps blowing your mind up. Why do you want to see him?
Mama, no, he defends me quite all right. I know he's doing everything he can.
Okay. Quick question, do you want to get laid by this lawyer? I mean, you have to pay me regardless.
Mama, no. You know, I have a thing for gums, and Chili chews the gum so sexy, unlike my former husband, that I feel like chewing his gum. But thanks anyway, Chili will bring you the money, I'm sure.
Next.
Hey, Mama, I brought some drink for you to relax a little.
Is there arsenic in this? Are you trying to kill me?
Mama, no.
PG, get it out of here.
Mama, no, it's just some lovely juice Billy brought for me.
Billy Flynn brought you this juice?
Yes, but please don't tell the other girls. I just thought I could share it with you.
How did you see Billy Flynn?
Well,
oh, you made a secret phone call and didn't pay me a dime, did ya?
Oh, Mama, please don't punish me. I'll do whatever you want. Please don't send me back to that cell again, please.
PG, have her phone the jailhouse show, please.
Right away, Mom.
Next.
My lovely Mama, my guardian angel, here's your 100 for this morning.
Finally, your responsible killer will kiss my ass.
Anything, Mama. Here's $200 for you.
Oh, and come back. What's with the attitude?
Attitude? Don't you want the money?
No shit, Sherlock. But this money you have to pay to be happy here.
Happy? I don't consider myself happy.
Well, maybe you should do something about it.
Maybe you should do something about it.
Are you telling me what to do?
Maybe you need to stop paying attention to other prison girls like Velma and Roxy and start paying attention to me.
Oh, huh? I see. How about this? I'll pay attention to you when you're important.
Which?
PJ.
Me?
Come on.
Me? You'll regret this, Mama. You will.
Next. Hey, Mama.
Stop right there. Do you have money first?
Please let me in. I just want to talk to Mama.
You know the rule, lady. Bring the money, then yourself.
Joanne, just let her in, for God's sake. Hi.
June.
Did you bring the rest of your money?
Ma, you know I couldn't earn any money this week.
Didn't you do some shows at some jailhouse? What happened to that money?
Ma, they robbed me, and I couldn't defend myself.
Oh, honey. Well, you did defend yourself pretty good against your husband.
Ma, he was jealous and annoying. And you know I didn't do anything.
None of you did, dear. None of you. Listen, June, you owe me $400. So here's the deal. I want to do a show, and if you partake in this show, I'll clean up your debt.
A jailhouse show? How do you plan on doing a show inside the jail? There are reporters and press everywhere. It's impossible to do such thing without their attention.
I've been running this jailhouse for more than you've been alive.
I get out of this hell?
Oh, soon, baby, soon. Just hold on a little bit more.
Mama, you don't understand. I want to sing. I want to dance. I need to be on stage. I need my lights back. Mama, please, what should I do? Guide me, please.
Come here, Mama. So, as you know, I've been planning this show for a long time.
What show? Oh, the jailhouse show.
Mm-hmm. And I think it's about time. What do you say?
Mama's show, yes. I can sing, I can dance, I can get my lights back.
Calm down, buggero. I might need to bring some other girls from other jailhouses, but it's fine.
Mama, okay, but let me perform too. I'm sick of this Roxy attention and I feel like I'm stuck here forever.
Don't worry, darling. Mama's got you. Okay, go. I'll count the money. Go. Joanne?
Yes, Mama?
Start the preparations for the 3rd County Jail Festival.
Right away, Mom.
County Jail Festival!
Wow, that's gonna be fun. I can't wait to see the prisoners' girls dancing. So, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for the County Jail Festival?
Lights!
Music!
Where's all my soul, sisters? Let me hear your flow, sisters.
Hey, sister, go, sister, soul, sister, flow, sister.
Razzle Dazzle!
Wow! Let's learn who he is!
trying to hurry.
Calm down, Wilma.
That's it.
Mama pays for it, it's not fair.
No, she doesn't. Mama talks to me all the time. One day I talk to Mama, one day Roxy talks to Mama, one day Mama talks to Mama, one day I talk to Mama again, the next day Roxy talks.
If you think you can annoy me, go ahead. Mama doesn't like you, she doesn't care about you. No child day for you,
no freedom for you ever again.
I know one thing for sure, you'll be forgotten soon, honey.
No one will remember you. Take it easy, Roma.
It's you saying that to me? Nobody even knows your name, honey.
That's it. Stop it, or else...
Or else what, baby?
Oh, what's going on here? I told you that I don't want any catfights here.
We were just chatting. Right, ladies? Hey, Cornelia, what do you know about that guy? What's his name?
You mean Mr. Razzle Dazzle?
Well, I do. I know more things about him.
Well, Mr. Razzle Dazzle is from New York. Real New York. Real man.
I heard that he's such a hot man and a real gentleman.
I heard that he's a wizard. He has magic.
Oh, stop it. He's going to visit you ladies along with two other lawyers today. They must be here soon. Let me check them.
Oh, we'll meet Mr. Razzle Dazzle.
Try not to fall in love with him.
Well, my favorite lawyer is still too ego.
But what makes Mr. Razzle Dazzle so special? Well, I guess we'll see it when we see him.
They're really curious. Let's go and get ready.
Her lawyer.
You're not my lawyer. Get out of here, you dumb shit.
Oh, Miss
Mr. Flynn?
Oh, hi, Trixie. What a woman, huh? And the major celebrity, too. She is both rich and guilty, just as I like her.
Okay. Did you get my trial date?
Yeah, I'll get to it.
Billy, I want to discuss my trial, too.
I'll get to it. Oh, is she okay?
Oh, don't worry about me. I just hope the fall didn't hurt the baby.
The baby?
Crap.
Do you have a baby? Oh, come on.
I don't see how we can delay the child even one more minute. My readers will stand for this. They want Roxy and her baby to be done.
I can assure you, Roxy will come to child. At the earliest possible moment.
It seems that Roxy's pregnant.
But where's the father?
Charlie, nothing. Or is he?
But if not Amos, then who is it?
We'll wait and see for it.
Hey, everybody. Hey, I'm the father. Hey. Did you hear me?
No.
Story of my life. Nobody ever listened to me. You think I'm making up?
No.
Nobody never knows I'm around. Not even my parents noticed me. One day, I went to school. And when I came back, they moved.
Hey, Amos. Thought you could need a hand.
A hand for what?
I heard that you were fooled by so-called lawyer Billy Flynn.
I thought I was a father.
Oh, Amos. You will be father someday, my friend.
Not from the woman I love. She fooled me too.
Which is exactly why I'm here for.
What do you mean?
What I mean, Mr. Dietary, is that I will defend you on the court and make sure that everyone will know that you are not the father of Roxy's baby.
Maybe. I'm still a father, can't I?
Amos, are you telling me that you still want that murderer with her baby, which is from another man?
Maybe. I want the middle of the baby's father.
Like, you can raise your child, but cannot be the father. Do you want to be the father?
No. Hell no, bro. Hell no.
Of course no. Get a grip. Pull yourself together. Do you want to spend your whole life with the lady who cheated on you 1,000 times?
Hell no!
Yes, that's what I'm saying! Hell no!
So, what are you suggesting?
What I'm suggesting, Mr. Daddy, to be, like I said, I will defend you on the court and make sure that you will have a voice during the trial of Roxy.
I should have a voice.
You should have a voice!
I want that lady dead!
You want that lady dead!
That child too!
And that child too!
And that friend guy too!
And that friend! Oh, Amos. This guy is already dead, you know? Anyway, I will do my work. Don't worry, but it will cost you a fortune, you know? Do you have $5,000 to pay me?
$5,000? You want the same money?
Well, if you can't afford this kind of money, then you should raise the Roxy's child. Choose your side.
I'm sure we'll not. I will have to sell my house then. Deal.
Deal. Let's go to my office, my friend.
Give will be the truth, the
I certainly do.
Well, we shall begin. Question by Sergeant Fogarty. What happened next? Answered by Mrs. Roxy Hart. I shot him because he was going to kill me. Signed by Roxy Hart. Recognize the signature?
Yes.
That is the signature of the woman who used to be my wife.
Great. Take the witness, Billy Flynn.
Hello, Amos.
Amos. That's right, Mr. Flynn. My name is Amos.
Do you want to divorce the defendant, Miss Hart?
Yes, of course. The newspaper said that she's expecting a baby. But this is the stranger for me.
And by that, you mean you may not be the father of the baby.
Yes, the baby's a stranger to me.
Did you even bother to ask her, the mother to be?
Well, no. You told
me. Just jump to conclusion. What if Roxy Hart swore that you are the father of her baby, which she does?
She does?
I do.
She does. Step down, Eddie.
Roxanne, you stand.
Do you declare in the film that the evidence you shall give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
So, Roxy Hart, I have here a statement which you admit to having a romantic relationship with the dead Fred Casely. True or false?
True or false? I'm afraid that's true.
Oh!
Oh, an honest girl. I love romantic relationships. Go on.
Okay. And when did that begin?
When I let him drive me home on a rainy night.
Hey, Chicky. It's raining cat and dogs, eh? I got my new car around the corner. Why don't you I take you to the home? It's raining so hard and all.
Yet you were married to Mr. Hart.
Wait a minute. Let's all finish.
I don't think I would have gone with him if me and Mr. Hart hadn't had a fight at that very morning.
Had a fight? I object.
Rejected.
Okay, go on.
I told him I don't like working at that cheap place and I don't like him work such long hours at that garage. I want you home with me, I said. I want to wash your socks and iron your shirts because I want to be a real wife at a real home. And the baby, obviously.
Aww.
Then why didn't you continue this affair relationship with the dead Fred Casey? Why didn't you end it, Roxy Hart?
I said that I wanted to. I tried, but Mr. Fred Casey would beg me to stay and kept saying,
please, Roxy, please don't leave me. I can't live without you. Please, you're my sunshine.
Sound like he was insistent.
Roxy Hart, the state has accused you of the murder of Fred Casey. Are you guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty.
Objection!
Denied.
I killed him, yes, but I'm not a criminal.
There. Roxy, can you recall the night of February 14th? Tell the jury your own way. What happened?
I was on my way home from work about 2 a.m. and stopped at an all-night market for baking powder to make cupcakes for my Amos. And I was getting ready for the bed, and then the doorbell rang.
Ding dong!
I thought it might be a friend in need, so I slipped on my silk kimono and went through the door.
Hey, Roxy, it's me. Please. Let me see you once more.
Objection! Oh, come on! Too much drama here!
I know dramas. Shut it up!
That note you sent me? Why did you write that note, Roxy?
Because it's all over! I've seen the errors in my ways. And...
Did he go away like you asked him?
Oh, I object! Leading the witness!
Rejected.
So, what did you say?
I said... Go away! So what was I saying? I was trying to force the door because he was going to come to my house and I ran through the bedroom, but he followed me. Fred, no good will come of this. Besides, I love my husband.
That's me, her husband.
Sit down.
So, you told him that you love your husband. And what did he say to them?
You're mine, you're mine, you're mine!
Objection!
Rejected. Let the story go on.
I can't go on, I can't!
You must tell the jury everything. You must tell me the whole story.
Okay then. Amos and me are going to have a baby.
Wow!
I will get there. I can't handle another man's child.
Are you writing all this?
Wait a minute. In his rage, he tried to pull off my silk kimono and threw me across the room. Mr. Hart's revolver was laying there between us. He went for the gun.
And then
I knocked it from his head.
Objection!
And then we both reached for the gun.
And then
I got it first.
Oh!
He was coming at me with the funny look in his eyes.
I mean to kill you.
Do you think that he meant to kill you?
Yes.
So it was his life or yours?
And not just my life. So I closed my eyes.
Roxy!
And my son!
Please!
In defense of your life?
To save my husband's innocent unborn child.
Your Honor,
who are you?
Excuse me, Your Honor, for interrupting, but I could not just sit there, standing and watching and doing nothing. Your Honor, you and I have never killed, but Roxy Hart has been through so much pain that this monster has barged into her house and threatened not to take one, but two lives that night. Roxy Hart shot him. I'm not saying that she didn't do that. Roxy Hart has begged for forgiveness, and nothing will bring back Fred Casely. Maybe we can't give her happiness, but we can give her another chance. I rest my case, Your Honor.
Okay, it's time to reach a decision.
All right, the judge has made a decision.
We find the defendant
guilty!
Not guilty!
Your Honor, the jury has to come to a conclusion. Defendant Roxy Hart is not guilty of her crimes. Roxy Hart is pregnant. She cannot go to prison while trying to raise a child.
Okay then, let's ask to the audience, is she guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty!
Oh, come on!
Okay, I'm giving the decision. She is not guilty!
Let's go.
I can't believe I lost again!
Congratulations!
Finally! I'm not guilty!
Roxy?
What do you want?
I want you to come home. I still love you. And the baby.
I'm not sure, Amos.
But our baby. And I'm the father.
There is no baby, you fool! I fooled everyone! And you were fooled again!
You fooled me again? I lost everything! My wife, my child, and this asshole took all my money!
Wait, Amos, I am actually pregnant!
You cannot fool me again!
Amos?
I can't live with this! And my name's Amos! Oh!
Oh my god!
Oh. Amos! Oh! Well, he must come anyways.
Oh, Billy!
Can you shut up for one time in your life? You know, it's all because of you!
Me? What have I done?
You and your life caused all these! And you know what? What? Roxy and this dude died. They shouldn't, but they did. But now, brother, you shall die. You shall. I don't know where it's the gun, but I find it now. Yes. And lawyer, Billy Flynn.
You don't want to do that, Chili.
Come on!
Your face.